I just hope that you all have purchased your new edition textbook, which is Lakhmir Singh Science Biology for ICSE from S. Chand Publications. Students, these are the contents of your textbook and these are the chapters that you will be studying for the session. We started from chapter number 1, which is Organization in Living Things, and we will continue with the same chapter. But before that, I want to give you an important instruction. Students, you all have two practical files, right? So in one practical file, you will be doing all your homework, right from 10th homework. And just make sure that you're writing well, you're writing neatly, and that too in good, proper handwriting. And you have to draw diagrams neatly there. And in other practical file, you'll be doing practicals and experiments. Students, will continue with the same chapter, chapter 1, Organization and Living Things. We have done simple permanent tissues and its types. Now we'll be doing complex permanent tissues and its types. Complex permanent tissues are the types of tissues which are made up of more than one type of cells, and these cells, they coordinate to form a common function. Now these tissues are also known as vascular tissues. Why? Because their function is to transport water and other minerals to all the parts of the body of the plant. Xylem is a conducting tissue, is a direct conducting tissue, and its function is to transport water and dissolved minerals from roots to other parts of the plant in upward direction. It is composed of different types of cells. They are tracheids, vessels, xylem parenchyma and xylem sclerenchyma. They also provide mechanical strength to the plant. As we all know that plants also need energy, and they get this energy from the food they prepare during the process of photosynthesis. Now there is some method by which they can transport food to other parts of the plant. Now this transportation of food from leaves to the other parts of the plant is known as translocation. Now food is stored in the plants in the form of sucrose. So plants transfer this sucrose to all parts of the plant through the tissue known as phloem tissue. So phloem tissue, it is a living conducting tissue unlike xylem tissue, and it is bidirectional. That means it moves downwards and upwards both. So it is bidirectional, and xylem is only unidirectional. That means it moves only upwards. Then a phloem tissue, it is composed of four different types of cells. They are sieve tubes, companion cells, phloem parenchyma, and phloem fibers. Animal tissues. Now, on the basis of the functions they perform in the body of multicellular animals, animal tissues are classified as epithelial tissue or epithelium, muscular tissue, connective tissue, and nervous tissue. Let us take epithelial tissue first. Epithelial tissue is the simplest tissue. It is the protective tissue of the animal body. This tissue covers most organs and cavities within the body, and it covers the outermost covering also, just like the outermost covering of the packet or any box. Now this tissue helps our body from the environment, like from heat, cold, rain, etc., and it separates the internal organ also. Now this epithelial tissue, they are found in the lining of mouth. They are found in the blood vessels and the kidney tubules. Now epithelial tissue, they are further divided into depending upon the shape and function of the cells, they are classified as squamous, cuboidal, columnar, glandular, and ciliated epithelial tissue. Squamous epithelium or squamous epithelial tissue. Now, squama is actually a Latin word and it means scales. And these cells, they look exactly like the scales on the skin of fish. But scales on the fish, they are very hard, but these cells are very soft. And these cells, they form the delicate lining of cavities like mouth, esophagus, nose, then alveoli, etc., and of blood vessels and covering of the tongue and skin. Their function is to protect the underlying parts of body from mechanical injury, entry of germs, chemicals, and drying. Now, the second one is cuboidal epithelium. Now, just like the name, these are cuboidal in shape, and these are found in kidney tubules, then thyroid vesicles, and in glands like salivary glands, sweat glands, and exocrine pancreas. It forms germinal epithelium of gonads like testes and ovaries also. And their function is to absorb and to excrete and to secrete. And it also provides mechanical strength. Columnar epithelium or columnar epithelial tissue forms the lining of stomach, small intestine and colon, forming mucous membrane, and it also forms lining of gallbladder, oviducts and facilitates movement across the cells. The functions of columnar epithelium tissues are, it includes absorption, for example, stomach, small intestine and secretion, for example, mucus by goblet cells or mucous membrane. Then comes glandular epithelium. Glandular epithelium is actually when the columnar epithelium is modified to form glands which secrete chemicals, then it becomes glandular epithelium. Ciliated epithelium or ciliated epithelial cells. Now certain cuboidal, you can see this, certain cuboidal or columnar cells have a free border which bear thread-like cytoplasmic outgrowths called cilia. And this cilia is actually the specialization of epithelial cells, and the cilia helps in the movement. So these this type of epithelial tissues, they are found in the respiratory tract, and this cilia helps in the movement of mucus. These are also found in the bronchi, kidney tubules and oviducts. So the rhythmic beating of the cilia moves solid particles. As I told you earlier, it helps in the movement. So it helps in to move the solid particles in one direction through the ducts.